I was about hearing this and I'm like, no, I just have to talk about this. So I feel like if you want to avoid spillage in your bag, you can use a knife. Hey beautiful people, welcome back to my channel. What has happened? Today I'll be sharing with you guys all the things I packed to Canada as a food lover. Of course, I'm not going to eat all the flavors in Nigeria. A chef, a new mom, and all these things helped me. So I'm doing this video because I know that in order to prepare for my journey, I had to watch other videos here on YouTube so that I could make a list of items that I would need in the course of relocation. I'm also making this video because I think it will be helpful to someone. So if you're that special someone, please keep watching. Okay, so I'm just gonna start out with the leaves that I brought. I brought a lot of leaves, as in leaves that I'm very conversant with, leaves that I have used all in the dry form. So I'm just gonna start with the leaves and then after that, I'll talk about something else. So here I have with me editan leaves. If you're from Kwashiba, if you're from Afang, or you've actually been with these people, you know what this leaf is like in the fresh form. So it's basically prepared just like the Afang with water leaves and then your proteins, and that's just it. So here I'll be preparing it with spinach. I'll show you guys when I prepare this. So I have like 3 sacks of editan leaves. So this is 1. This is 2. And this is 3. Oh, my baby is away. The second. This is Afang. 3 sacks. So good. Afang leaves. Really yummy. I'll still show you guys how I make this now. I'll let you know if I actually liked it. So, oh, sorry. So, this I have here with me the atama leaves. Atama, I've forgotten what it's called in English. Is it the belented? I don't know. I'm just going to put the name, the real name of this leaf here on the screen. So it's used for banga soup. It's just, you just sprinkle like a handful on banga soup depending on the quantity you are making. I have scent leaves for banga soup. So these scent leaves, I washed, dried and sliced it myself, and I used the dehydrator, like my air fryer, to dehydrate it. So I mixed some curry leaves inside it so that I have like some kind of flavor. I love you baby. Some kind of flavor if I'm using it for like some porridges or whatever the case may be. I have utazi leaves. This is for my pepper soup, abacha, or whenever I think I need it. This utazi leaves has like a kind of bitter taste, but since it's well dried up, it's not as bitter as it is in the fresh form. I love you. This is just scent leaves, seeds, just in case if I need to use them. And I have the ewedu leaves. I haven't made this before, but I just thought like if I eat amala and ewedu, why not? I need to get this. I could actually start practicing how to make amala, ewedu, and bugiri here. I don't know if I got that right, but don't kill me. So I have this bitter leaf. I actually use this bitter leaf to make this yummy soup. Just don't worry, I'll show you guys this ogbono soup like the next day. Yes, I'll be foodie. So I have this about 2 sacks of bitter leaves. I bought these bitter leaves in fresh form and then I washed it myself. My brother actually helped me wash it and then I dehydrated it. This is another ewedu leaf. So yeah, I think that's for the leaves. Next thing I brought is the melon. I have some ground melon as well. So I divided the melon. I got like two custard pints buckets of melon. So I blended one custard pint, and then I left one in its raw form. In fact, I think I blended one and a half. Baby. So this is it. Some cornflakes. Some spices here. This fish seasoning, this is not the only one I have. I had to cargo about 188 kg of items because the food items I brought with me are like a lot. I just bought something that can last me over time in large quantity. So I bought this. My babies, that's my baby. So I bought this Chinchin. I bought two of this custard. I bought this. Yeah, I bought this. So I packed this as baby food. Was the baby cereal, naan milk, and all baby food. So I got this big bowl. Can you see? We call it in reverse state ogbono. But I don't know what it's called in your native language. I bought some sardines and butter, although the butter is completely mashed. These are the sardines. I bought about 24 pieces of sardines. I bought ukwa. I'm not really like a fan of ukwa, but I was thinking of packing snacks and I'm like, why not? This uziza seeds for pepper soup or whatever. Banga seeds. Bitter cola. The crayfish Maggi seasoning. Indian fruits. The acabomites call it uyaya. Let me show you guys. Yeah. For pepper soup, white soup. Some people even use it for native dishes like curry chicken or whatever you want to use it for. This is still the uyaya. Another uyaya. The little pepper, osoji, seasoning cubes, seasoning cubes, seasoning cubes. What is the baby? Dehydrated for one. What's dehydrated by me? More egusi. Ogbono. Ogba. Some stockfish. Morocco, some dried apple snails and tiny snails. Let me show you what it looks like. Yeah. Can you see apple snails? So you can either eat it just like. Because of this video, I'll explain to you guys how I packed my fish in such a way that there was no smell of fish in my bag. Just keep watching to the end. Fishes, stock fishes, more fishes, more fishes, more fishes. So I have other spices. Sachet tomato. I have like 2 packs of this crayfish seasoning. I think 5 packs of knorr. 5 packs of knorr seasoning cube. 5 packs of onga cubes and 3 packs of star seasoning cube. So now we're going to be talking about the star of the season. And it is Her Excellency, Abi, His Excellency. My baby's here. The palm oil of the season. So I had like 10 liters of palm oil. This was how I wrapped my palm oil. I froze it for about 2 weeks. And then the morning, on the day I was supposed to leave, I packed it, like I wrapped it. So I had, this is like 5 liters. And this is like 5 liters. Oh my God, it's so heavy. And so I'm just going to be unwrapping this to show you guys what it looks like. When I arrived Canada, it was still very cold. Like I think it was still frozen to an extent, not as frozen as I took it out from the freezer in Nigeria. So I'm going to be unboxing this here. I also bought some garri, beans, and some other things. Like I mentioned, the reason why they're not here with me was because I had to cargo the items. So those items from the cargo company, according to the cargo company, those items will be arriving within 5 to 7 working days. Wrap number one, cello tape and newspaper. Still very cold. This is the palm oil and it's still very cold. You can see that it's wet, but the nylon that I had used to wrap it in the first place did not allow the moisture to seep through or even get anything in my bag wet. After turning the palm oil into the keg, before I put it into the freezer, I had to like use a bag to cover the mouth. So here's another palm oil and I'll be unwrapping this as well, and then later I'll let you guys know why I wrapped it like this. So we have like 10 liters of palm oil here. 10 liters. This is the ground melon, if you see that I put in the fridge so it doesn't get bad. And the ground ogbono. I also have Nescafe, 3-in-1 Nescafe. Have you tried this particular seasoning in your stews or jollof rice? Hey, it's a banger. Just try it and thank me later. I have my Milo, another Milo, and my all-time fave, Cadbury. More jollof signature. To show you guys that I got some drugs. Okay, this is not included. I got some drugs like antibiotics, and I had prescription from Med Plus. I had vitamin D drop for my baby. I had paracetamol, vitamin C for myself. This reload, in fact, and lots of other drugs. I got this quickly from my friend in Nigeria. So I have been snacking on this like every minute. It's really yummy. Thank you, Pauline. And the color is great. It doesn't have any sand. also brought my body care essential. I was about hearing this and I'm like, no, I just have to talk about this. So I feel like if you want to avoid spillage in your bag, you can use a nylon or a clean film to wrap maybe your cream, your face wash and everything. I didn't have any spill aside from my face wash. So after it spilled, like the whole spilling was within the clean film. So it didn't actually affect anything in the bag. So this is the importance of wrapping, like sealing your body cream or your soap or any liquid thing that you be traveling with for emphasis. Listening to this hair mousse, so the same thing for my body wash as well. So I actually cover some things like food items, my clothes. And so these are not like all the things that I brought. When I received the cargo, I'm going to unbox them and let you guys know what else I cargoed. What I'm going to do is, after arranging everything in the house, I'm actually going to do a video showing you guys what I brought, like for emphasis. I don't know if I've forgotten anything. Okay guys, so I did say I was going to show you guys how to trap in the smell of fish or crayfish in your bag, so that when you pack it, your bag will not be smelling fish or camarón pepe. So this is my fish. I left this one on purpose so I can show you guys. So the first thing you do is pack your fish according to the quantity you want in a Ziploc bag or any transparent nylon, and then use another nylon to support the first nylon. So what you're going to do is, in the second nylon, pour in some black coffee, like Nescafe, you know, that bitter one, ganga. The smell is really strong, so it's actually going to overshadow any smell of fish, pepper or crayfish in your bag. So let me just unpack this and show you what I mean. Now, can you see, I was able to tear the nylon, and if you look at it, you see some black stuff here. I don't know if you guys can see. Let me go closer. So that's the Nescafe, and look at it here. So the Nescafe was able to help trap in the smell of the fish in this nylon, so that even if you smell my bag, you wouldn't even know if I have fish inside. So that's just how to pack your fish. I advise that if you know it's certain that you will leave, I advise that you start buying things in bits, because it really helped me. I had to prepare. I had a lot of time to prepare. I started buying my things in bits. Yeah, I know you might be thinking, those things might get bad and all. No. So I'm thinking of making a detailed video on how to preserve these food items so that they are in good condition. If you bought them before, like for a long time, let's say a month before your set date of travel, if you want me to make this video, please let me know in the comment section. Also, I'm thinking of helping new moms like me. I mean, traveling with babies can be scary. I was anxious myself. I was very anxious, so I had to like go to YouTube to see if there are any tips that might be helpful for me. Did I find? Yes, I found, but were they very, very helpful? No. If you want me to create a detailed video on what to pack in your carry-on luggage for your newborn to make your travel seamless, very comfortable. Okay, so it's not like it's going to be 100% perfect, because you know, like for my baby, it was her first time flying. The first time I flew with her was when I was pregnant, of course she was there. And so this time I did all I could to make the journey seamless. So if you want this video, do let me know in the comment section. Please like, subscribe to this channel, share these tips to your friends and family. So I'm trying to make this video as short as possible, and I'm going to end this part one here. The part two will be when I receive my cargo. So I'll be leaving the list of items I brought in the description section of this video, so feel free to go through it just in case if I have missed anything in the course of shooting this video.